Hi, I'm Brian, and welcome to my world, a world that I love and that I've become a part of. Welcome to the world of theater. My fascination in the theater started in elementary school, in an after-school program for young actors. In that program, we learned how to play theater games, act, build sets, and put on shows. Now I'm in high school preparing to graduate and pursue a career in theater. Now, when I was your age, I saw a lot of plays, and I still do. And I hope that, like me, you can make a connection between what you see in the theater and what you're learning in class. In fact, that's why this video was made, to help prepare you and your teacher for what you're going to see here at the Capitol Center. What is the Capitol Center? Well, it was a theater built in 1927 for vaudeville acts and showing movies. Well, what's a vaudeville act, you ask? Well, it's a collection of humorous skits, songs and dances, acrobatic and magic acts. It was the most popular form of entertainment at the turn of the 20th century, up until 1930. You may have heard of some of the headliners of vaudeville, Harry Houdini, Jimmy the Great Durante, or Will Rogers. They all began their careers playing in vaudeville circuits. In the 1930s, when radio and motion pictures became really popular, most of the vaudeville theaters were converted into movie theaters. The Capitol Center, which was known back then as the Capitol Theater, was showing movies too. And a lot of people who grew up around the Concord area remember going to the movies at the Capitol Theater. Over the years, the Capitol Theater also became a place where you went to see concerts. Classical musicians and rock bands played there. And over the years, the theater started showing the wear and tear of all those people coming to see movies and concerts. It became really, really dilapidated. I mean, it was bad. In fact, the guy who owned it was going to tear it down and replace it with a parking lot. But then a bunch of people in the town got together to save it and fix it up. It took a lot of money and a lot of hard work. And now, nearly 30,000 school children filled with anticipation and excitement, just like you, come to the Capitol Center to see shows. In fact, they come from all over the state of New Hampshire. Today, I'm here to help you prepare for your visit, so you'll know what to expect when you arrive at the theater. And to help you better understand the show you're about to see. Now, long before you go to the theater, lots of people have done lots of work to help plan for your visit, most especially your teachers. Theater companies from all over the United States, and Canada too, have sometimes spent years to develop the show you're about to see. They write the script, hire actors, make costumes and sets, and write the study guides that your teacher received before going to the show. These study guides help your teacher prepare you for the show you're about to see. They include information and activities you can do in your classroom. Months before you see the show, the theater companies have contacted the Capitol Center to let them know what the show will need in the way of lights and sound so that the show will look good and sound good to you and the audience. On the day of the show, crews arrive at the theater, many times before dawn, to unload sets and costumes and make the stage come alive with the show you're about to see. Some of the people who move in with the show are the actors, and sometimes the director. That's the person who decides where the actors will move on the stage, how the show will look, and what kind of feelings you should experience. There's the stage manager. Now that's the person who makes sure the actors are where they're supposed to be, and that the show you see is the same one that the director created back in rehearsal. Sometimes there is a bunch of people in charge of costumes and sets, and sometimes the actors do it all. Chances are that when you go to the show, you might get on a bus with all of your classmates and travel to the theater. While you're getting on the bus, the house manager has arrived at the theater to make sure it's clean and ready for you. The house manager prepares for anything you might need while you're watching the show. They check the lobby where you first enter the theater, they check the bathrooms, and they check the theater itself to make sure the lights are on and it's clean. When you arrive at the theater, you'll walk up to the doors where the house manager will greet your teachers. The house manager has a large staff of ushers who volunteer their time to help you find your seats and to help with anything else you might need. Don't be afraid to ask them questions. Your teacher will check in with the house manager and an usher will take you into the theater and show you where your seats are. Now it's time to talk about theater etiquette. The theater is a special place where it's necessary to show a certain kind of behavior because the enjoyment of everybody in the audience depends on everyone being courteous and respectful. That means you take off your hat. No eating in the theater. and no drinking in the theater. And spit out your gum. And applaud to show your appreciation. While you're waiting quietly for the show to begin, you can enjoy the interesting architecture of the Capitol Center for the Arts. When you're inside the theater, you'll see it's decorated in an Egyptian motif, or style. Remember how I told you that the theater was built in 1927? Well, in 1927, that style of decoration and architecture was very popular in theaters because of the discovery of King Tut's tomb in Egypt in 1922. This discovery caught the imagination of the American public, and the Egyptian style influenced the style of architecture, clothing, theaters, you name it. There are things that you should look for to let you know that the show is about to start. First, a Capitol Center staff member will walk out on the stage and introduce the show. Then the lights will dim, and then music may start. When the lights go out, this is when the magic starts. This is the interaction between the actor and the audience. This is an exciting moment, and allow yourself to be drawn into it. You can think about what you knew before, what you were expecting, and how your thinking has changed as you're watching the show. Also, think about the conventions of theater. Are people playing animals? Are the actors singing to tell the story? You see? I don't have to help you because... At the end of the show, somebody from the Capitol Center will return to the stage to dismiss you. Little do you know that there are lots of people on walkie-talkies all over the city organizing the buses back to the theater to pick you up and take you back to school. Then, as you leave the theater, is when crew starts to take down the set. They call it striking the set, to travel to another theater and do it all over again. Think about what has happened since you've left school. You've been invited to a different world. New questions have been brought to your mind. You've developed new understandings to what you thought you knew. Your thinking may have changed. You've been opened up to a world that offers opportunities to you as an adult in the workforce. You've learned appropriate behavior to use in any theater you might go to. You've spent time with children from other towns. Your teachers may be interested in coming to workshops or to learn about other performances. They may want to visit the Capitol Center website at ccanh.com and download study guides that meet New Hampshire's curriculum standards. This concludes our video presentation. I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you find this video helpful in your visit to the Capitol Center for the Arts. And enjoy the show.